Good morning, everyone. Today's editorial has been chosen from the newspaper Business Standard, dated 24th of April 2020. The article's title is Fear Factor Again. Industry right to question definition of negligence in COVID cases. Okay? So let's read this article and find out what this is about. The spread of COVID-19 or coronavirus disease 19 and the extended nationwide lockdown to contain it have brought economic activity to a virtual standstill. ठीक है, economic activity लगभग रुक गई है, थम गई है. In this context, the government did well to allow business to resume selectively in designated areas from April 20, as the experience would be critical in deciding the future course of action. Consider April 20 cutoff date for resumption of economic activity as a trial period, where you try, where you open up few areas and then observe whether cases increase or decrease or are stable, and then you decide the future course that needs to be taken on the 3rd of May or beyond that. So April 20 was that date when some businesses and some sectors were opened up in some areas, and it can be considered as a trial, and that trial's result will decide the future course of action. However, some rules attached to the resumption of economic activity have led to confusion and apprehension among Indian businesses. Apprehension ka matlab hota hai the feeling of anxiety, the feeling of not knowing what is going to happen, and that fear settling in your mind, that is apprehension. So however, some rules attached to the resumption of economic activity have led to confusion and apprehension among business, Indian businesses. The fear is that the managements would be punished if employees are infected by the virus. है ना, अगर कोई फैक्ट्री है, अगर कोई इंडस्ट्री है, अगर कोई शॉप भी है और उसके एम्प्लॉयज़ को काम करते वक्त अगर वायरस इन्फेक्शन हो जाता है, तो द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ दैट इंडस्ट्री, द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ दैट फैक्ट्री, द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ दैट शॉप और दैट सेटअप विल बी पनिश्ड. दिस इज इंक्लूडेड इन द गाइडलाइंस दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैज इशूड फॉर रिजम्पशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी post April 20 and even beyond May 3rd. Clause 21 of the guidelines issued by the Ministry of Home Affairs had noted that company managements can be deemed guilty and punished for negligence under the Disaster Management Act in the case of COVID-19 incidents at workplaces. Incidents is occurrence or happening of something. Okay? So specifically, editor ne bata diya कि मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स ने एक सेट ऑफ गाइडलाइंस इशू किया था जिसके क्लॉज 21 में ये लिखा हुआ था कि कंपनी मैनेजमेंट्स कैन बी डीम्ड गिल्टी एंड पनिश्ड फॉर नेग्लिजेंस अंडर द डीएमए इन द केस ऑफ कोविड-19 इंसिडेंट्स एट वर्कप्लेसेस. क्लियरली इट विल नॉट बी इजी टू डिटरमाइन वेदर एम्प्लॉयज आर गेटिंग इन्फेक्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ द नेग्लिजेंस ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट और सम अदर रीजन. ठीक है, नो एम्प्लॉयज मे बी अफेक्टेड वाइल वर्किंग, but was that infection spread or caught from inside the premises of that particular industry or factory due to the negligence of the management, or was it due to the negligence of the workers themselves, or was it infiltrated from the outside or came from the outside? That is hard to decide, so it won't be easy to determine this, whether the employees negligence led to that infection or was there some any other reason, which is a valid point to be asked here. So while the government has issued clarifications saying penal action would be taken only if complicity is proven, industry is not convinced, and rightly so. ठीक है, government ने government से जब ये सवाल पूछा गया कि भाई how will you decide from where this infection came and how will you decide whether the employees were responsible or was it some other reason, the government issued clarifications, and the government said ki penal action or penalties or punishments will be given only if complicity is proven. Now, complicity is the condition or the situation of being involved in something that is unlawful or not right or unjust. Okay? When you're complicit, you are involved in something that is wrong. You are involved in doing something that is wrong. So complicity is that situation where a person is said to be involved in doing wrong things. That is complicity. So if that complicity, or if that management's complicity is proven, only then will the penal actions be taken against them. But industry, the economy, the people working in the industry, the management's, they are not convinced, and they are rightly so, and they are right in not being convinced about it. Such rules give enormous powers to officials and often result in harassment. Okay? Power corrupts, more power corrupts even more. So that has been exemplified and stated in this sentence. Such rules give enormous powers to officials and often result in harassment. Now, while the government has the right to spell out the boundaries which would guide the staggered resumption in economic activity, the guidelines must be unambiguous so that they leave no scope for harassment of employers. ठीक है? To spell out को हमने पिछले वीडियो में डिस्कस किया था. When you spell out something, you explain it very clearly. Anything that is complex or not easily understandable by any layman, you break it into small pieces and make it very clearly, understood by a person, is to spell out, basically to explain very clearly. So while the government has the right to explain very clearly or state out very clearly the boundaries which would guide the staggered resumption in economic activity. So the state, yahan pe government ki baat ho rahi hai, the government has the right to decide as to when and how or where which kind of economic activity will resume. It falls under the jurisdiction of the government. The guidelines must be unambiguous. Now, unambiguous is something that is clear. ठीक है, जो कि जिसका कोई और दूसरा मीनिंग ना निकल सके. दैट इज़ वेरी डायरेक्ट, वेरी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड, वेरी क्लियर. दैट इज़ अनएम्बिग्यूअस. ये वर्ड बना कैसे? अनएम्बिग्यूअस में दो वर्ड्स हैं, अन और एम्बिग्यूअस. ठीक है, एम्बिग्यूअस में भी दो वर्ड हैं, एम्बी एंड ग्यूअस. एम्बी मीन्स बोथ साइड्स और सराउंडिंग. तो एम्बिग्यूअस मीन्स समथिंग दैट हैज बोथ मीनिंग्स और टू मीनिंग्स, or something that is surrounded by many meanings and not and any one meaning is not very clear, or you cannot say that it just has one single meaning, or that there can be only one interpretation of it. So that is ambiguous, something that is diluted, something that is not very clear or not very clearly understood is ambiguous. Unambiguous is called tau, something that is very clear and very easily understood. Now ambi is a prefix, जिससे और भी बहुत सारे वर्ड्स आपने सुने होंगे, लाइक एम्बीडेक्स्ट्रस. आप सबने सुना होगा लियोनार्डो डा विंची वाज एम्बीडेक्स्ट्रस. ही कुड राइट एंड ड्रॉ विद बोथ हिज हैंड्स एट द सेम टाइम. सो ही वाज एम्बीडेक्स्ट्रस, एबिलिटी टू यूज बोथ हैंड्स इक्वली. एम्बीवर्ट सुना होगा, एम्बीवर्ट अ पर्सन हु इज बोथ एक्सट्रोवर्ट एंड इंट्रोवर्ट. दैट इज अ पर्सन who is very outspoken at some times and very quiet at the other times is an ambivert. ठीक है, दोनों आ जा रहा है इसमें, extrovert भी हो रहा है, introvert भी हो रहा है. Ambience तो आपने सुना ही होगा. आप किसी भी नई जगह पे जाते हैं, किसी मूवी हॉल में जाते हैं या रेस्टोरेंट में जाते हैं, तो कहते हैं यहाँ का ambience अच्छा था या यहाँ का ambience ख़राब था. Ambience is the surrounding atmosphere. तो यहाँ पे वो surrounding वाला meaning इसका आ जाता है. Hence this word ambiguous. ठीक है, तो द गाइडलाइंस मस्ट बी अनएम्बिग्यूअस, सो वेरी क्लियर, सो दैट दे लीव नो स्कोप फॉर हरासमेंट ऑफ एम्प्लॉयर्स. इफ देयर विल बी क्लियर कट बाउंड्रीज डिफाइंड एज टू द ज्यूरिसडिक्शन और एज टू द प्लान दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैज इन देयर माइंड ऑफ व्हेन एंड वेयर एंड हाउ एंड विच इंडस्ट्रीज विल बी ओपन, सो देयर वोंट बी एनी स्कोप फॉर एनी हरासमेंट, देयर वोंट बी एनी लूप होल्स लेफ्ट. दैट इज व्हाट दिस स्टेटमेंट इज टेलिंग. For example, a legitimate question by industry is who will determine the definition of negligence or cognizance. Cognizance is awareness or knowledge of something. ठीक है, of employers. तो यहाँ पे एक example quote किया गया है ऐसे ही loophole का, कि a legitimate question, a valid question by the industry is who will determine the definition of negligence or cognizance of employers? Who will determine whether the employers were aware or had the knowledge that the virus has entered their workplace and they did not do about it, anything about it, and they were negligent about it? So who is the authority to decide, and how, what are the metrics on which you will decide whether the employers should be punished or not, whether they are complicit or not? Okay. In addition to several overzealous district administrations threatening industrial units with shutdowns, this will only increase the fear factor, and this must stop immediately. Overzealous कोई बहुत ही ज़्यादा उत्साही है, अपने हद से आगे बढ़ के काम कर रहा है, दैट इज़ ओवर जीलस. नाउ एनीथिंग दैट इज़ इन ओवर और एनीथिंग दैट इज़ इन अंडर इज़ ऑलवेज हार्मफुल. कोई भी चीज़ बहुत ज़्यादा या बहुत कम हो तो हार्मफुल होती है. ठीक है, तो जीलस होना अच्छी बात है. व्हेन यू हैव जील, इट मीन्स यू आर वेरी एनर्जेटिक एंड एंथुसियास्टिक, है ना, आप बहुत उत्साह में हैं और आप में बहुत एनर्जी है किसी भी काम को करने के लिए. But when you're overzealous, you go beyond your limits and beyond your capacity or beyond your positions to do something, and that may be harmful. So in addition to several overzealous district administrations threatening industrial units with shutdowns, this will only increase the fear factor. Isse aur zyada bhay utpann hoga, and this must stop immediately. It is extremely important for the government to recognize two important things at this stage. First, India is not in a position to extend the lockdown further and will need to open up the economy, perhaps in phases, as even a limited opening will give firms some respite in terms of cash flow. Okay? First thing that the government must recognize, that the government must acknowledge, is that India is not in a position to extend the lockdown further. 3rd of May ke aage aap lockdown ko extend nahin kar sakte, because then the economy will have been damaged by such a limit which would be not possible to be repaired or revived for a very long time. So this is what the first recognition or the first acknowledgement that the government should have, is that India is not in a position to extend the lockdown further and will need to open up the economy, perhaps in phases, or even a limited, as even a limited opening will give firms some respite, some relief, some de-stress in terms of cash flow, in terms of earnings. Clear? Both the economic and human cost of extending the lockdown will increase disproportionately from here on. Clear? Isme likha hua hai, both the economic and human cost of extending the lockdown will increase disproportionately from here on. If you continue the lockdown after 3rd of May, there will be disproportionate economic and human costs, and that would be easy to recover. It is also clear that given the fiscal constraints or the government's financial constraints, the government is not willing to actively support businesses. अब भाई अपना फिस्कल डेफिसिट मैनेज करें या बिजनेसेस को और इंडस्ट्रीज को स्टिमुलस देते रहें. सो गवर्नमेंट इज इन अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट पोजिशन हेयर टू डिसाइड वेदर टू अचीव देयर फिस्कल डेफिसिट टारगेट्स और टू एक्टिवली सपोर्ट बिजनेसेस. सो देयरफॉर इट इज़ क्रूशियल दैट द रूल्स ऑफ रीओपनिंग आर क्लियर विथ लिमिटेड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिस्क्रेशन ऑन द ग्राउंड. डिस्क्रेशन इज taking decisions at your will. आप जैसा चाहें वैसा करें, that is your discretion. So administrative discretion on the will or on the whims of the administration. So इसीलिए लिखा हुआ है, therefore it is critical that the rules of reopening are clear with limited administrative discretion on the ground. The position of company managements should not be akin to public sector bankers who have been reluctant to take lending decisions because of the fear of investigating agencies. Recall that phase of banking where bankers were reluctant, the bankers did not want to or were interested in taking lending decisions or taking decisions about giving out loans, because there were authorities, there were agencies that were hunting for bankers who were making bad decisions or who were not able to take good decisions about such lending processes. अगर किसी बैंकर ने कोई लोन दिया है और वो डिफॉल्ट हो गया, तो सीबीआई एंड अदर अथॉरिटीज़ वुड कम अप टू दैट बैंकर एंड आस्क कि भाई व्हाई डिड यू गिव आउट दिस लोन, व्हाई डिड यू सैंक्शन दिस लोन, वॉज देयर सम वेस्टेड इंटरेस्ट इन यू, और डिड यू एन्जॉय सम बेनिफिट्स फ्रॉम द बोरोवर दैट यू पास दिस लोन विदाउट यू नो लुकिंग एट अ डॉक्यूमेंट्स, विदाउट गॉजिंग द कोलैटरल एंड ऑल दैट, ऑल दोज थिंग्स. तो दैट लेड टू बैंकर्स नॉट गिविंग आउट लोन्स एनी मोर. नाउ दे वर वेरी एप्रीहेंसिव अबाउट इट, दे वर वेरी स्केर्ड इफ वी गिव आउट लोन्स एंड इफ दे डिफॉल्ट दे विल बी द वंस हु विल बी बिहाइंड द बार एंड नॉट दोज बोरोवर्स मे बी. सो दिस इज वॉट हैपेंड देन. ठीक है, द पोजिशन ऑफ कंपनी मैनेजमेंट्स शुड नॉट बी अकिन. अकिन दो वर्ड से बना है फिर से, ए एंड किन. किन इज समथिंग, सम वन हु इज योर वेरी क्लोज रिलेटिव, योर फैमिली मेम्बर. नाउ अ क्लोज रिलेटिव और अ फैमिली मेम्बर दे हैव सिमिलर लीनिएज, दे हैव सिमिलर कल्चर, सिमिलर अपब्रिंगिंग, हैंस दे आर कॉल्ड अ फैमिली मेम्बर. ठीक है, टू बी अकिन टू समथिंग इज टू बी सिमिलर टू समथिंग. तो अकिन कैसे आया, किन कहाँ से आया, ये आपको पता चल गया. सो अकिन इज समथिंग दैट इज वेरी सिमिलर टू समथिंग. सो द पोजिशन ऑफ कंपनी मैनेजमेंट्स शुड नॉट बी सिमिलर टू पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंकर्स हु हैव बीन रिलक्टेंट और अनइंटरेस्टेड टू टेक लेंडिंग डिसीजंस बिकॉज ऑफ द फियर ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग एजेंसीज. ठीक है, नाउ जस्ट बिकॉज देर इज अ क्लॉज 21 मेंशन्ड इन दैट गाइडलाइन इशूड बाय द एमएचए दैट इफ द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ एन इंडस्ट्री इज फाउंड रिस्पॉन्सिबल और प्रूवन रिस्पॉन्सिबल ऑफ एन वायरस इन्फेक्शन इन देयर वर्किंग प्रिमाइसिस, दे विल बी द वन हु विल बी प्रोसिक्यूटेड. सो दैट मे अफेक्ट देयर डिसीजन टेकिंग कैपेसिटी और मे इन्फ्लुएंस देम टू नॉट इवन नॉट ओपन अप देयर फैक्ट्रीज और इंडस्ट्रीज एट ऑल. That will be a worrisome situation because then there won't be any labor working despite lockdowns being lifted, and it will be difficult to convince them to open up their factories, industries, and carry on with the economic activities of production they were doing. So this should not happen. The government had done well to repeal unwarranted criminal provisions in the Companies Act. जब ये बैंकर्स वाला क्राइसिस हुआ था वेर दे वर नॉट गिविंग आउट लोन्स आउट ऑफ द फियर ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग एजेंसी, द कंपनीज एक्ट वॉज यू नो दैट अनवॉरेंटेड क्रिमिनल प्रोविजन्स इन द कंपनीज एक्ट वॉज रिपील्ड. सो सच अ थिंग शुड बी डन इवन नाउ. ठीक है, ओनली क्लैरिफिकेशंस बाय द गवर्नमेंट दैट ठीक है इफ यू विल पनिश यू विल ओनली इफ यू आर फाउंड गिल्टी वोंट हेल्प हेयर. Arbitrary decisions such as this should not undo the good work. The good work here is opening up the economy, not putting further lockdown restrictions on the economy. That opening up should not be, you know, उसके असर जो हैं वो ऐसे arbitrary decisions की वजह से खराब नहीं होने चाहिए. The things that you are expecting to happen after the lockdown ends should not go in vain because of such arbitrary decisions, such random decisions about punishing the management because of a virus outbreak. All right. Second, it is possible that the number of cases would increase with resumption in economic activity and infection may not peak anytime soon. ये आपने word कई बार सुना होगा during this pandemic, peak. ठीक है, पीक इज द हाईएस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ अ माउंटेन और हाईएस्ट पीक हाईएस्ट पॉइंट इन द ग्राफ, बियॉन्ड दैट पीक द ग्राफ फॉल्स और द स्लोप ऑफ द माउंटेन डिक्रीजेज. सो पीक इज द हाईएस्ट पॉइंट वेयर दिस इन्फेक्शन कैन रीच एंड वंस यू हैव रीच द पीक द इन्फेक्शन रेट और द ग्रोथ रेट ऑफ इन्फेक्शन विल सर्टनली स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग आफ्टर दैट एंड देर वोंट बी एनी अदर इंक्रीज इन द केसेज. That is the peak we are talking about here. So, the second thing that the government should acknowledge that it is possible that the number of cases would increase with resumption in economic activity. In lockdown, we have crossed 20,000 cases. If there is no lockdown, imagine the scenario. So, it is obvious, it is certain that the number of cases will increase. Okay? And the infection may not peak anytime soon. The maximum number of cases that India is going to be affected with may not peak anytime soon. In such a situation, going after company managers and directors will not solve the problem. This is an absurd step in the first place. How prosecuting company managers and directors helps in not spreading the virus. Therefore, the government should now work on a broad exit strategy with clearly defined rules. It will be important to ensure that operating conditions do not take India back to the era of Inspector Raj, which will only increase economic difficulties. आपको Inspector Raj के बारे में पता होना चाहिए. Between 1947 and 1990, the economy of India was running under the ambit of Inspector Raj, where there were regular inspections and every economic activity was in some way or the other guided or overviewed or in the control of the state. State कहने का मतलब यहाँ पे central government की बात हो रही है. तो there were inspectors responsible at the local level where they would visit industries, inspect whether everything is up to the mark or not, or whether labor is properly working in healthy environment or not, and all such things, whether all rules and regulations have been followed or not. And they had the power to issue licenses. Those industries which matched these conditions would get the license, others won't. This was also called license Raj. This was also called license permit Raj. So these are all other names for this. One thing that needs to be ensured is that the operating conditions do not take India back to that Inspector Raj era. All right, जहाँ पे इतने ज़्यादा sanctions थे, इतने ज़्यादा inspections थे कि productivity level बहुत ज़्यादा नीचे थी. The major drawback of Inspector Raj and the reason why it was repealed or done away with was that it had led to very less productivity. So we must, the government must take this thing into consideration and ensure that the operating conditions for businesses is not such that it goes back to the Inspector Raj era, and it will increase the economic difficulties after that. This is not to suggest that firms should not take appropriate measures to ensure the safety of their employees. Iska matlab ye nahi ki the management should be very easy going about all those social distancing norms and hygiene norms, but the government needs to strike a balance. It must recognize that businesses across sectors are under severe stress, and ill-judged conditions can just end up killing them all. Theek hai, this is what today's article was about. It talked about the Clause 21 that has been included in the guidelines issued by the MHA to the industries that have been opened up in India after April 20th, and how they are regulated, how that reopening of the economy is being regulated, and how at what points it can hamper all the goodwill that is behind such opening. So this is what today's article is about. I hope you understood all of the things. You can ask all your doubts, and if there is anything that I left that needs to be discussed, can be pointed out in the comments section. I'll also put up one or two questions in the description box so that you can answer and get a clearer understanding of this issue. So thank you so much. This is me signing off for today. Have a good day. Thank you.